Just recently as well, I've been out to Menangle Park again, and we've covered this event since 2011, since it first started.
We have, yes.
Yeah, the Indigenous harness race.
Great and to see how it's growing more successfully
and that was,
each year.
And that was the big thing, is sort of seeing it now in its sixth year. Jimmy and Brown and of course the major sponsor, Michael Brown, have done such a wonderful job in starting it from, yeah, such a small little race to now, you know, a metropolitan race, and, you know, the stature's grown with it, and you know, it's a great day out there, family fun day. Lots of people, lots of our mob too, and that's the great thing. You know, it's a real community day, and lots of Aboriginal people getting out there and enjoying the day, and also, you know, enjoying the actual event. So let's take a look at the story now. Jimmy Brown has been around horses longer than he can remember. His dad took him to the old Harold Park Paceway in the heart of Sydney, and he was instantly hooked. Fast forward a few years, and Jimmy would drive his maiden winner in 1994. Now, over two decades later, the popular harness racing figure is still pulling the right reins.
I fell in love with the horses. Then when I actually got into it, you actually fall in love with the people as well. You know, I've got that many friends like throughout Australia because of it. Of course, there's good and bad everywhere, but 99% of the people are just champion people. And, you know, the animal itself is just a beautiful animal.
His career has seen him land over 350 winners and has also been a trainer of some success. One of Jimmy's finest drives was in the 2008 Group 1 Queensland Derby, where he led from start to finish on Standell.
Brown pulled the persuader on Standell. Benny Mac's not going away. I'm Full of Fire, getting out late and screaming home. Standell in front and won!
It's even good just to win a normal little race. It's top feeling, but when you win the big ones, or even when you're in the big ones, it's just a real big buzz, and the whole atmosphere is different. Like, you know, everyone's wishes to have a horse in a Group 1 race, and then when you have one in it, it's actually good, but when you win it, it's just sensational.
But ask Jimmy Brown what his biggest achievement in the sport has been, and no doubt the 44-year-old will say starting the Indigenous Drivers Series. After seeing the success and pride that came with the Maltese Drivers Invitational race, Jimmy wanted to do something similar for his mob.
The main idea was, like us older fellas, trying to get the young kids to put up and say, I'm Aboriginal, I'm proud of it. And well, as you can see now, look, we've got reserves, and, you know, look, yeah, we've got five races around out in the bush, and hopefully bigger and better next year. So, you know, it's all about the kids putting their hand up, and, you know, any kids out there, if they want to get enhanced racing, give us a yell.
The first Indigenous Drivers Invitational was run in 2011. From very humble beginnings and with little fanfare, it has grown into a premier metropolitan race.
Thank you very much.
Now known as the JC Caffin Indigenous Plate, major sponsor Michael Brown says it was an easy call to get behind the race, especially after meeting Jimmy all those years ago.
His passion for the harness racing horse, but his passion for his community, for his people, and that's what I love, people who've got passion, you know, and you can't beat that. So that's what dragged me into it, and I thought, well, you know, I've got to take this somewhere, you know, with him. I've got to come on his journey, you know.
But if you're on the late mail runner, Snoop Stride, get in the queue. Snoop Stride at big odds with you.
The Caffin Indigenous Plate is now a series with five lead-up races that finish with the final held at the home of harness racing in New South Wales, Menangle Park. This year's edition was the biggest on record. The 1,609-metre event was boosted by an extra $5,000 in prize money and had a full field of 12 horses plus emergencies. The race is also memorable because Aboriginal culture takes centre stage at the annual Fisher's Ghost meeting. Uncle Ivan Wellington from the Darawal people has delivered the welcome to country and smoking ceremony every year since the race's inception. He stands proudly along with the Aboriginal flag flying above. Once again, the driver's silks were designed by talented artist Randall Green.
We've had a great relationship with the local Indigenous community. Uncle Ivan Wellington's been a fantastic supporter of our club, and he's helped to guide us, because, I mean, what we want to make sure is that we're being respectful in the way we do things. And what was fantastic today was the number of people that gathered around for that smoking ceremony and for the dances.
This year's race was taken out by Royce Gregory-Jack, who drove the favourite, Rave Moonraker. The victory was Gregory-Jack's third in the six-year history of the event.
The class of drivers getting better, and the class of horses getting better, and so the series is getting better. Like, it means a lot. When I saw the fields and the way that horse had been running lately, I thought I was pretty confident, really. You get a lot of adrenaline, like, it's hard to explain. Like, it's like anything when you win, like if you win a grand final in footy or something like that, it's similar, you get a feeling of euphoria.
Jimmy Brown started this event with the twin aims of getting more of our mob into harness racing and giving people the chance to be proud of their identity. People like Jack Wade, who is so fresh to the harness world that the Caffin Indigenous Plate was just his seventh drive.
Been around horses my whole life. My dad's trained gallopers for 20 odd years. He owned a couple of paces about 16, 17 years ago, and you don't have to be a certain weight to compete in the races. It's always a good day. It's one of the best things the industry's done to promote Indigenous people in the industry.
Wade made his way through to the final by way of winning a lead-up heat in Wagga Wagga.
But arrived in time, certainly has arrived in time. Driver is jubilant, arrived in time one.
It was a pretty big win, like it's been 7 years since me track work fall to get back and to even just compete in a race, and then to win a race like that, it was a big thrill. So yeah, I kind of got a bit pre-umped early with the salute, but oh well, they didn't find me too much for it.
Jimmy and Michael Brown are already talking up next year's running and have promised more surprises for 2017, but are tight-lipped about what they might be.
This race meeting will get better. I've already got in my head, I've already got planned. I know what's going to happen next year. I'm not going to tell you, like I did last year, I'm not going to tell you then. But it's just going to get bigger and bigger and bigger.
Oh, I just love it, you know, like, and we're getting pretty tight, us, all the drivers and that, so it's good, you know, we get down the bush and have a laugh and carry on, and same is here today, so I can't wait till next year. All the drivers here today showed their talent, and we're not far beyond anyone.
Jimmy Brown has never won the race he began, and the name Jay Brown would sit nicely alongside previous winners. But he won't get it easy from the other Indigenous drivers, and that's just the way he likes it.